another type of hyperbola. Now, if you take, this is our standard hyperbola like this. If it is rotated by an angle of 90 degrees, it will come like this. Now, this is standard equation x square by a square minus y square by b square equal to plus 1. By rotation of 90 degrees, it will become x square by a square minus y square by b square equal to minus 1. We discussed this point in translation rotation, x is equal to x cos 90 minus y sin 90 and y is equal to x sin 90 plus y cos 90. That means this will become minus y and this will become x. Now on substitution, this curve will change to this type of format. Now let us discuss the detailed properties of the conjugate hyperbola. So if the original hyperbola is rotated by an angle of 90 degrees, the new format is called conjugate hyperbola. So this is called conjugate hyperbola. Now, for our understanding purpose, let us write hyperbola will be like this. Now, this is center, this is B, B dash, A, A dash, as usual. Now, we will write first, center is equal to 0, 0. Here, vertices are given by 0, plus or minus B. Foci are given by 0, plus or minus B. Then comes equation of directrix is given by x is y is equal to plus or minus b by e. Equation of lattice rectum is given by y is equal to plus or minus b e. Then comes eccentricity is given by e is equal to, previously it is root of a square plus b square by a square. Now, in place of A, write B. In place of B, write A. This will become root of A square plus B square by B square. Then, tangents at vertices are given by Y is equal to plus or minus B. Now, very important point is AA dash is called conjugate axis. Conjugate axis. Length is equal to 2a, whereas you are having equation is, since it is along x-axis, y is equal to 0. BB dash is called the transverse axis. Now, length is equal to, that is 2b, and equation is x is equal to 0. Now, all the properties we listed out. Let us shift the origin from 0, 0 to h, k. The new format of equation will be like this. So here we can write center is equal to 0, 0 plus h, k leads to h, k here. Then previously vertices are given by, that is 0, plus or minus b increased by h, k means h, k plus or minus b. Then foci is equal to 0, plus or minus b plus h, k. It is h, k plus or minus b. Now, equation of directrix is given by, here previously y is equal to plus or minus b by e. So, y is equal to k plus or minus b by e. Then comes equation of lattice rectum is given by y is equal to k plus or minus b. Now eccentricity will not change. E is equal to square root of a square plus b square by a square. Then tangents at vertices are given by y is equal to k plus or minus b. Then here we forgot one point. Length of lattice rectum is equal to 2a square by b. Here also, length of lattice rectum is 2a square by b. Here, AA dash is called conjugate axis. Conjugate axis, parallel to x-axis. Then length is given by 2a. Equation is y is equal to k. Then comes BB dash is called transverse axis, comma, parallel to y axis. So length is equal to 2a, I'm sorry, 2b. Equation is x is equal to h. We observe one logic very clearly, that there is simple minute changes because of shifting of origin from 0, 0 to h, k.